You know, it's hard to believe that these rocks, this coal, helped us win two world wars, powered generations of Americans,
and literally built many Appalachian towns, like Inez, Kentucky.
Coal is our history, coal is our DNA. We're coal miners. We have been for many, many, many decades.
My grandpa was a coal miner. My dad was a coal miner.
My brothers were all coal miners. My brother-in-laws were coal miners. Everyone I know is coal miners.
All my uncles was coal miners. My other grandfather was a coal miner.
We're coal miners and we're proud of that fact.
It's rough work. It's not anyone can do it. And it takes a special breed of people.
Inez has the rather dubious honor of being a stop on President Lyndon Johnson's 1964 poverty tour. Lon Lafferty would like to shake off, or at least shake up, that decades-old image.
Prior to the development of the coal industry, we were living in fairly abject poverty throughout this region. But as you look around today and you see the finer homes and the finer automobiles, nicer schools, people that are educated, coal has played the most important part in that.
What is this place?
This is Martiki Coal. It's been here for years. In the big silos out there, they would have big piles of coal around them, three or four dozers pushing into these feeders and pushing it onto the belts and then cleaning it and then loading it onto the trains. Been here for years. It employed a lot of Martin County citizens at one point. When I was younger, there was actually businesses around here, and this place was booming, and it was actually a beautiful place. And the coal industry left, and this place has kind of went down a little bit, so here we are. Hoping to bring it back up with these solar panels.
You heard that right. Solar power is coming to Kentucky coal country, and in a big way.
We're here today for the first jobs fair for the Martin County Solar Project.
Like many great stories, this one begins with failure.
I lost an election, and I wasn't independently wealthy, so I needed a job.
Welcome to Adam Edelin's field of impossible dreams.
I have endured a lot of taunts. I've been told for the 5 or 6 years that we're in this that it would never work, that no one would want to work on a site like this, that these folks preferred their past to their future.
There was so much coal here, a mountaintop was removed to get it. That left 1,200 acres of mostly unused level ground, perfect for a utility-scale solar power plant. It will generate 200 megawatts of electricity.
That's enough to power about 27,000 Kentucky homes.
Ironically, the same substation that fed an energy-hungry mining operation will now send solar power back out to the grid. Hugely expensive infrastructure that really made the project possible in this remote, rugged location. 440,000 solar panels will be installed here in two phases, employing more than 300 people.
There's a tremendous number of families that have been affected by the loss of the coal jobs.
We're here in Martin County. The unemployment rate is above 10%, the state's highest.
So we see this as an opportunity, maybe not the greatest opportunity, but at least an opportunity.
The downside? All but a dozen of these jobs will be temporary, lasting about 24 months. But judging from this job fair turnout,
I knew I wouldn't get a parking spot when I pulled in. So that's just the way it is.
People here want to work.
We're real prideful people, and we do take our work seriously. Call somebody lazy around here, you better be ready to fight.
Is it safe to say that people in this region are not searching for a handout, that what they want is opportunity?
They want opportunity. They don't want a handout.
Big, it is bold, and it is unapologetically ambitious. But if we're going to save the planet, we have to expand the winner circle. And what we have demonstrated powerfully is that if you give people an opportunity to improve their lot, they're going to seize it. We've proven it here in Martin County, Kentucky.
So your grandfather, William Fred Lafferty, if you could speak to him today, what do you think he would think about getting power not from the ground, but from the sun?
First of all, he'd be amazed by the technology, but also I think hopeful for the technology and hopeful that the technology would benefit our region. Most of the people here certainly that live here, they're born and raised here, love the mountains. They want to see a better way, a better day for the mountains. So I think my grandfather would be right there and be very proud and think that it's a shining moment for us.